was in the Annunciation, which we looked at in our last film, the moment of Mary's conception of Jesus starts to become shared here. So she's heard the news that her elderly kinswoman Elizabeth, who lives a little bit outside Jerusalem, is also pregnant. It's as wondrous almost an event as the fact that she is, because she's a virgin. Elizabeth was thought to be barren and too old to have a child. And we hear that the Virgin Mary goes out to the hill country and is greeted by Elizabeth. And there's this wonderful moment of intimacy and welcome. And also there's a sense of the meeting of the two babes in their womb, because John the Baptist is to be the child of Elizabeth. And he leaps in her womb, almost as though he's recognizing the Jesus who's in Mary's womb. So there are sort of two meetings here, one visible and one invisible.
I love the way this German artist has expressed this, the excitement of this moment. In this limewood carving, these two women are coming together, and as you can see, their draperies are flowing behind them as if they've rushed to greet each other. And this object we should imagine as actually part of a much larger structure. In fact, it probably formed part of an altarpiece in a German church in the Tyrol, and it would have formed this lower part known as a predella. So you may have had a series of scenes from the life of the Virgin and much larger scenes above them, so a very grand, monumental structure. But these two figures would have been quite close to us, the beholder, at the foot of the altar. Here, as you describe the gospel accounts of these two women meeting, and when we see the scene represented in painting, we have a lot more visual context, don't we? We often see them meeting in a landscape. And so when I come to these sculptures, I imagine this verdant landscape behind them. The gospel accounts describe how Mary goes out of the city and goes into the hill country. So we often see these rolling hills. And I'm minded of a painting that is in the Gemäldegalerie here in Berlin by a French artist called Jacques, Daret, painted in the 1430s. And there you see these two women greeting. And much like this artist, there's always this interesting moment where the women either clasp hands, as they do here. Elizabeth places her hand on the pregnant belly of the Virgin. And there's often this very charged moment between them, the space between the two women. There's this understanding of those two pregnant bellies also meeting, as you describe, the unborn children meeting for the first time.
And it's a charged space in part because, as it's described in the New Testament, the Holy Spirit is sort of highly active here. God's Holy Spirit is what's bringing these miracles to be, and is not just animating the women, but sort of animating the whole of creation through them, and that the landscapes that you often see in these visitation scenes are sometimes springing back to life. Mm-hmm. Because the birth of this child that Mary's carrying is going to bring about the renewal of creation more generally. So that interior event becomes a shared event and eventually is going to be shared with all of creation, human and animal and vegetable, everything is going to come into this renewed state. This is also the moment at which Mary famously utters a song, which is known in church tradition as the Magnificat. It's a song of praise, but also of triumph. And that song has lots of literary echoes of a Jewish victory hymn of the sort that would have been sung by Jewish revolutionaries at a time not long before the New Testament was written. It speaks of the mighty being put down from their thrones and the humble lifted up. We find these same sorts of words on Mary's lips. This is a revolutionary moment as well. Mm. And as we look at these two women who at this crucial moment are absolutely at the center of the biblical story and the story of salvation, we're, I think, encouraged to see them in Mary's song, not simply as passive recipients of instructions from God or anyone else, but actually agents of renewal and salvation themselves. And another central line in the Magnificat is Mary saying of God, "He that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name." So she acknowledges how God is celebrating her, magnifying her, and at the same time acknowledges God's holiness. And in our next film, we're going to look at how she acknowledges that holiness after Jesus' birth, and how one particular artist has interpreted that in visual terms.